There's bridges being built there. There are, there's bridges. Any orange men in? It's cold rain, come on! Who's in a lodge? Come on! Anybody? There's more peepish in than I thought. It was a good 12th last year. No, it was. No, the year before they burned down a house in Shankill.
It's traditional.
And I have a friend that lives over the Shankill, social worker, Jackie. And Jackie, I think, has discovered the solution to contentious parades such as Ardoyne. There's only a couple left. And I think he is, because you know the Orange Order always get the Scotch bands. Takes about a week to go 10 yards. Jackie discovered, see if this band, the Orange Order used this band, it would solve the whole problem. Look at them, a band on bikes.
Can you imagine the wee orange men running behind that? Can you imagine the wee order? They'd be up past the Ardoyne shaft before the Fenians had even wakened up.
Another artist does this, puts my face in different images. Did you ever take a moment to think who you'd be and what you'd believe if you were born three streets to the right or three streets to the left? Dingy P and Sinn Féin don't like me using that one. What I love about the 12th is that the insanity reaches an apex that I don't believe can be matched anywhere else in the world. Last year, Belfast City Council decided to store pallets belonging to bonfire makers. Well done, you think to yourself. Then they discover them pallets had been stolen. Shock, horror. When we all know they're always stolen. So being an ethical council, they decided to return the pallets to their rightful owner. But before they could do that, somebody stole them again. Nobody knows who stole them. Nobody. But Bangor Bonfire was the bollocks last year. Problem of Bonfire and Bangor was they did not know the pallets they had stolen originally belonged to Sandy Row. And you don't steal anything from Sandy Row. So the Bangor boys had to go out and steal more pallets to replace the stolen pallets that they had stolen the first time. I love that city. Is it only me, again? But do some Northern Irish businessmen all look eerily similar? Bald as a billiard ball, fake tan cap teeth, wee suits. It's like it's a factory somewhere.
Sicko in a suit, yeah!
This is a very small place. This tour, that has come home to me in a very real way, okay? I was doing that in Belfast, done the show. After the show, I go, anyone wants a picture taken, that's fine. Want a picture, say hello at the end, I'll come out and say hello. As long as you know how to use your mobile, do you understand? That's all they ask. So this woman comes up, lovely woman, says, Jay, could I have a picture with you? Of course you can, love. My husband's going to take a picture. Who's the husband? Deaston! Who, thank God, has a sense of humour. But what I was thinking afterwards, can you imagine being sitting beside him in the audience when I'm doing,
second one is shoot.
Don't laugh, don't laugh, don't.